If you have a scene that was well modeled and textured, but still it looked average, then the problem might just be your camera angle. In this video, I'll show you 7 cinematic angles you can start using today to instantly improve the quality of your renders. Whether you're visualizing a skyscraper or a cozy interior, camera angle defines how your viewer experiences the scene. Today, we'll break down 7 game-changing angles, from dramatic lows to elegant overheads. And more importantly, when and why to use each one. If you enjoy this type of content, don't forget to check out my ebook, Mastering Composition in Architectural Visualization. It's packed with techniques like these and more. Links in the description. The first one is using a low camera angle for power and dominance. You want your subject to feel strong, important, or monumental. You can frame upwards, but don't distort your scene too much unless it's a style you are going for. The next one is using an eye-level camera angle for realism and balance. You want the scene to feel grounded, relatable, or observational. This works well as it mimics how people actually experience space. Third one is using a high-angle shot for context and scale. You need to show how your building fits within its environment. Here's a quick tip. Use my Lightroom presets to make that light and atmosphere prominent from above. Next, use a wide shot camera angle for spatial drama. You want to emphasize space, openness, or environmental storytelling. You can use the rule of thirds here for balance and tension. Number 5 is using a framed shot for depth and mood. You want to add intimacy or focus the viewer through a visual window. This helps create a narrative, like someone discovering the space. The next one is using an over-the-shoulder camera angle for immersion and a first-person view of the space. You want the viewer to feel like they're inside the scene, which is great for animations or stills. Last but not the least, is using a tilted camera angle, also known as the Dutch angle, for tension or artistic flair. This enables you to create unease, energy, or break symmetry. Use this carefully, as too much of it can make your shot look disconnected or distracting. Each of these angles can totally shift the emotion of your render. If you want to enhance it further, combine it with the right color grading, and you will have a cinematic scene. So go ahead and check out my cinematic Lightroom presets in the description section below. Here's a challenge. Open one of your recent projects, and instead of picking your default camera position, test out 3 of the 7 angles we just covered. Render quick previews, compare them, and ask yourself, which one tells the best story? If you want me to feature your work in my future videos, send me a DM on my Instagram or send me an email. Let's summarize the 7 camera angles. Low, eye level, aerial or high angle shot, wide, framed, over the shoulder, and the Dutch angle. Remember, these are tools for emotion, story, and connection. To go deeper into visual storytelling, check out my ebook, Mastering Composition, and my Lightroom presets to instantly enhance your renders. Don't forget to like this video if it gave you some value and subscribe if you haven't already. Let's keep creating visuals that leaves a lasting impression. If you're ready to fix those flat renders, then watch this next video where I walk through why most scenes fall flat and how to fix them with just a few smart composition tweaks.